In this video, you're going to learn how to create a link tree without any code and using only the EditorX platform. This is a great way to save some money and have complete control over your link tree's design and functionality. I call it LinkitX. I publish a YouTube video twice weekly. You should probably subscribe. And I like to keep my link tree up to date with my latest video so that I maintain the facade that I'm good at Instagram. But I keep forgetting to do this. And it's a tedious manual process to copy the YouTube link, log into LinkTree, paste it, switch it on, and then do this twice a week. It's an absolute waste of time. Now I know I could upgrade my LinkTree and pay $10 a month to simply have the ability to have my YouTube video automatically update on my LinkTree, but I just can't bring myself to spend the money. I hate wasting money, but I also hate wasting time. So I'm really only left with one option. I have to build my own LinkTree. So friends, let's start out with a fresh EditorX site, editorx.com. It's free, go check it out. Start from scratch here with a blank canvas, and that's gonna open up a nice fresh site for me here. All right, this is what I wanna create here, or recreate. I wanna go to my current link tree, and it looks like this. It's very simple, there's nothing crazy. It's got my profile, my handle, a little one-liner bio, and then we've got my latest video here hidden in a little toggle. And I always have to manually update the latest video 2 times a week, and I always forget. Then a link to my CreativeX crew, and then a link to subscribe to the channel with some socials at the bottom. So very simple, shouldn't be crazy. But this is the main issue here. I want this to be a video that's always displayed, the latest video, without me having to pay for a premium link tree. So going back to my EditorX here, we got a section here, and I'm gonna add a background image. Very simple in the inspector design, choosing an image here that I already uploaded to my site files. Uploading that, and I'm gonna maybe play with the opacity a little bit, bring it down, maybe like 80% perhaps, but it's got a white underlay. So I'm gonna change the background color to actually black. And now I can play more with the opacity to see where I want it. And something like 40% looks pretty good to me. It's hidden in the background, but enough to give the vibe of the CreativeX brand. Go ahead, add an element, bring in a container. And I'm gonna get rid of that background, just pull that opacity all the way down to 0. I want it to be 100%, but I want the maximum width to be like 620 pixels. So if it's smaller than 620, it's gonna stretch to the full screen width. And the height's gonna be 100 VH for 100 viewport height, minimum height of 600 pixels so that it doesn't get any smaller than that. Make sure that's aligned properly, and so far, so good. Now I'm gonna add an element. I'm just gonna bring in an image and put my profile image in there. So it's just a default image here. We're going to change the image. Here's my profile, upload that, and I want it to be a square masked in a circle. So it's gonna be 80 pixels by 80 pixels. And then in the design settings of my inspector, I'm gonna change the border corners rather to 999 pixels, just makes it a circle. Perfect. And then I want to select this whole container here, and I want to give it a padding of like 30 pixels on all sides. Now I can take this logo, headshot, dock it right to the top. Now we're going to have space from all edges. I'm going to bring in a title here. I'm going to edit this, and it's actually going to be the style of an H5, like maybe a heading 6. But it's gonna have the H1 tag for semantic reasons, for SEO. That's gonna be white, it's gonna be centered. I'm gonna change that to my handle, @BradHussey. I'm gonna bring in a paragraph now. Edit that text, I'm gonna make it 100% width, centered, and aligned to the center as well. Same with this title, it's gonna be 100%, and then aligned center, just so it's always stretching out the full width of this container. So I'm gonna select this, I'm gonna change the color to more of like a light gray. Now I'm gonna select all three of these, put them in a stack that will allow me to fine tune the spacing between each of the items. Let's throw in a 10 pixel difference in between each. That looks so neat and tidy. We're on our way. Here's what we got next. We got that video. Now what we need to do here is embed a video, and I'm not gonna use this toggly thing because I hate it. So what we need to do is go to your YouTube, and I've created a playlist here with all of my latest videos that I've added. Then in order to responsively embed this, we need to go to a website called embedresponsibly.com. You embed the URL of the video you want to embed, and it will spit out a responsive snippet of code. But we want to embed a playlist, not a single video. So I took my playlist, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that link, paste it in. But we have a problem. It doesn't recognize it. It does something weird to the URL, but the rest of the code is good. So I'm actually going to replace this little bit with a better syntax that actually makes this work. So it's youtube.com/embed/video-series-query-string-list equals the ID of the playlist that you want to embed. Now I can go back to my editor X, add an iframe, drop it into this stack, paste that code, update, and now here is the playlist embedded with the latest video that will always show up whenever I upload a video. So let's make that iframe 100% of the width, and I want that height. Right now it's about 260. I want to make that about 320 pixels. That looks right on the desktop view, but if I resize this to tablet, then it's fine because the container's the right width. It's not wider than the tablet, but on mobile view, it's too tall and the rest of the text and content below this will be too far away and look weird. So we're going to select this, make the height something more like 50 VW for viewport width. And that creates a bit more of a variable height that works responsively. And that looks very, very nice. All right, so now I'm going to add a title in here. I'm gonna edit that, make it 100% width, and then make sure it's got space from everything. So we're actually gonna create a bit of a stack here between the title and the video. And then I'm just gonna make that item spacing 20 pixels. Now I'm gonna grab that bottom stack and the top stack, and I'm gonna stack the two of those together, which gives me some more fine-tuned control of the margin between the two. So now going back to my current link tree, I have these links. So I got the video done. That solved a big problem. I want to add these links and then some social icons on the bottom. So we're going to go back to our editor X. I'm going to add a repeater and drag it into this stack here. Then I'm going to select the repeater itself, change it from cards to list, make the width 100%, and fine tune its layout. Going to select the top item, which is what all the other items use as a reference. So that'll allow me to design one item and the rest will follow suit. So selecting this top item, going to the design, I'm going to make it dark. And the height of this item is just going to be like 50 pixels. And now what I want to do, because I can't really see them, the dark background, there's not a lot of contrast. I'm going to actually make this background section, I don't know, maybe a little brighter. It kind of does something. It doesn't do too much. Maybe what I'll do is I'll add a little bit of a border to these repeater items and make it a little bit white, 20% opacity. That works for me. We'll go with that for now. We might not keep it, but we'll see. So now I'm going to do is add a little bit of vertical margins between each of the repeater items. And now I can actually apply a grid to the first item, drag that over so that we have kind of 0.3 frame width, go into advanced mode, add a gap in between those two grid items. And now in that left cell, I can actually add an image. And that image is gonna be my CreativeX Crew logo, stretch that to fill. And then I'm gonna add a button, attach it to the right cell, and I'm gonna fill that width 100%, align it properly. And I'm gonna remove the background color, and I'm also gonna remove the border radius on the button, set it to 0. Maybe 5 actually. I don't even know if you'll see it, but oh well. So I'm gonna copy this text and I'm gonna paste it into this button here and update the link to actually link to my CreativeX Crew. And then I'm just going to update the font size and the spacing of this button just a little bit more. I'm gonna remove that border. I don't actually like it. All right, now I'm gonna duplicate this title here. So I'm just gonna call this something like My Links. Very, very creative. Gonna space that out a little bit. Since it's in a stack, it should be pretty easy for me just to update that item spacing. Very nice. Now I wanna add my social bar, my social links here, just like in my original link tree. Editor X has a really easy pre-designed social bar that you can just drag in, pick any of these styles. But I actually created my own style with white social icons. So I'm just gonna drag that in, align that properly. I'm going to duplicate that. I'm going to drag it down here above the social bar. Make sure that is aligned properly. We got enough spacing between. And then I'm gonna change that text. Now this container, I want it to have a little bit more padding on the bottom of the screen. So I'm just gonna select padding bottom, 60 pixels, and that looks good. All right, and now these links here, I actually want, when we hover over them, I want them to have that effect that's on the original Linktree site. So these kind of bounce, grow, whatever we call that. So I'm gonna actually recreate that by clicking on the repeater item, go to the interactions in the inspector, add a hover interaction, and we're gonna change the element that is being affected by choosing the element itself, the repeater item on the canvas. Then the action, we're gonna apply an effect. It's gonna be grow. You can leave this all as default. You can change it if you want. And then now we publish that and give that a little looksy-poo. We should have that effect, but I'm noticing a whoopsie here. The button has a hover effect and it's getting cut off when it zooms up. Let's fix our whoopsies. Gonna click on the repeater item. I'm gonna make sure to select the item, first one, and under overflow content, we want to show. So anything that overflows outside of the container, it'll show. Click the button, change the hover state to just have no background. And that text should just remain white. I don't want it to be doing anything crazy on us. Let's check that out in the browser and see what it looks like. Yep, that's what we're going for. Perfect. All right, is she responsive? You bet. That's nice and responsive, looks good on all the sizes. Let's hit that publish and copy this link, replace this with my Linktree on my Instagram now. It's official. Edit that profile, change that website to my new Linkit version of Linktree that I built myself in EditorX. And there it is, click that. It's gonna take me to my brand new Linkit that I made in EditorX with no code. Well, a little bit of iframe HTML, but that doesn't count. There we go. I built my own Linktree that auto displays my latest YouTube videos, shows off my links, and if I wanted, I could also collect emails or sell products directly within the page, all using EditorX. You should try it out for yourself. If you like this video, you can show your support by literally tapping the like button. Or better yet, you can join my free community for professional designers, creatives, and agency founders. It's called CreativeX Crew. We hang out every week, we share our work, we give feedback, we collaborate, we have challenges. It's a lot of fun, totally free. Join up today, the link is in the description. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss my twice weekly videos, which are now auto-updated on my Linkit. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.